Yellow duckies, let's get back into the game.
I'm also the one who wants to speak sense. Senus Owen. The southwest courtyard of Mirba is flanked by two guard towers. Between them, stoneworks are shaping and treating stone. Even in this chaotic time, Yucatish and Ariel traders are here to buy Mirba's fine materials. A merchant and craftsman notices you browsing. He walks up and speaks. A Havenite. A very rare honor. I am Samus Owen, and I am a stoneworker and trader here. Tell me about this workshop. Rock and dirt out of the honest sun. We've been working the rock on this patch of dirt for centuries. Mirba earns its bread here. We all have our specialty. I deal in fine stones. Fine stone. Aye. If you want to make a big wool, talk to them over there. I sell the finer stone and crystals from more unusual and remote quarries. You are an Owen. I am. Fell into misfortune. I work and trade here on behalf of my master. I can't talk to her though. She's gone. Where's your master? I'm not sure. Traveled to Vitassa a few months back. I understand she never arrived. Sad thing. I do the work. And I wait for news. I have another question. Tell me about Mirba. It's an oasis. Safest place in this region. The governor kept us so. Don't know the deals Vir Alar Masha made to keep the battles away. Glad he did. You approve of the governor? I imagine I do. Sure, I am an Owen, but the Masha still exist. I have to give credit to those who do right by me. Buy something. Aha, he's got roots. Okay, we want. Actually, no, we don't. Don't need anything. Senus nods, then he silently returns to his work. Another guard tower. Stairs of a guard tower. Okay, let's go and talk to the governor. Apparently, he's holding this whole place together with his own two hands. Vir Alar Masha. This is an ancient hall. The stone floor is worn with deep ruts left by centuries of leaders, guards, and honored visitors. There's a man sitting at the end of the stone table. The last 3 years have left him weary and broken. He looks you over, barely able to summon the energy to respond. Finally, he decides he has no choice. He rises to shake your hand. I am Governor Vir Alar Masha. I have been trusted to rule Mirba. And who are you? I'm Princess Viola, Governor Vir Alar's Masha Nott. I'm honored, Princess. So Haven is back at last. Very interesting timing. You arrived when the world was unstable, as I'm sure you've seen. You're welcome in Mirba, however, there's something you must know. And what is that? I care about my city. We are in delicate balance. The rebels do not destroy us because I do not fight for the other Masha. The Masha do not sack us, because they think I am not helping the rebels. I will deal with you. However, I cannot loudly take sides between the Owen and the Masha. interest in helping anyone. So you will end Haven's earlier policy with us. That is a bold but questionable decision, Princess. You'll find that the Masha are valuable allies, and we will pay you well for your aid. Anyway, I am free to talk. Just understand that I have my limits. I'd like to know about Mirba. This is a proud city, as old and with as storied a history as any in the bowl, if not as wealthy. Much of our finest stone comes from the quarries around here. How old is the city? Nobody is sure. These walls are at least 5 centuries old. All born in Mirba know that the city is a gift to them, and it is our responsibility to pass it on to the next generation. That is why I am trying to keep the two armies of this war from sacking it. How has Mirba fared in the war? I have led us down a dangerous path. I control the city, and I have made us neutral. Loyalists and rebels have come to our streets. I'll trade and drink here. I have made us an oasis, and in the bowl everyone can come to an oasis. And both sides accept us. Yes, but only through the most careful diplomacy on my part. I have not had a full night's sleep in 3 years. I have punished raiders and thieves on both sides. Soldiers from both sides have been in our stocks. Both sides have grudges against me. It is the price I pay to keep my city safe. I'd like to discuss the one. Severe LR Rosemary. We are nervous about discussing our practices with the outsiders. They are often too eager to judge without taking time to understand us. I'm sure you know the basics. When a free roll goes too far into debt, a masher can pay that debt. In return, the free roll becomes Owen and must serve the masher for life, plus another generation or two, or two more, if the debt is high enough. What do you think of the Owen system? It maintains the honor of our people. And it brings justice. If someone is lazy and foolish and loses a fortune, why shouldn't that person be punished? Why should others suffer to pay the debt of the Owen? Pay your own debts. It is the honorable Vold way. Why did the Owen rebel? Perhaps we Masha were not wise. Perhaps we let things grow too difficult for the free people of the Vold. Too many taxes, too much debt. It grew too easy to become Owen. When the Masha win the war, I'm sure they will introduce reforms. How many Owen do you own? I have 2 double-line Owen. I assure you that I treat them well, and I will treat their children well as well. After all, they are my workers, but they are not slaves. Are Owen ever mistreated? Of course, sometimes. It is very dishonorable. Much shame attaches to those who mistreat Owen. They must then take their Owen from the cities into the wastes. Few Masha let it go that far. They aren't slaves.
No.
And they will be very offended if you call them such. They are true Vol. They can have their own homes, families, beliefs. I can't sell them to others. They serve only me and my descendants. It is simply that, when they work, they must work for me, doing what I say. Double line Owen. My Owen let their debts be so great that not only they, but their children must serve my family for life. Unfortunate cases. I bought them because I pity them. And I wanted them to work for a family of status. Another question. I have some Dave's business to discuss. He leans forward as his eyes grow sharp. Do you? Of course. I may be able to help you within limits. The quartermaster of the South Battalion has a message for you. He would like to establish trade. A guard comes forward. Governor Viola Masha whispers to her. He leaves the Great Hall for a few minutes. When he returns, the governor says, "Thank you for this information. I will send merchants through the Vol gates. Once trade is in place, we will make sure that you are rewarded." I want to rebuild Haven's forts. I see. There are Fort West Bay and Crossing Keep, yes, on land we promised you. They are your forts. I'm sure you can rebuild them. We Masha want to show that we are useful to you. Fort West Bay is west of the Tassa. To get to Crossing Keep, pass through the Thibelin Pass to the west, and go south. I have rebuilt one of Haven's forts. Yes, the Masha helped with this. We made sure General Aquila's caravans and guards were safe from raiders. The Masha only want to be useful to Haven. In return, we hope you're useful to us. I have no more business. Alright, please have some more refreshments. No one refills, you've got some plates. That is all. Then please enjoy the safety of Mirba as the only oasis for miles around. Disturb. This is the way of the pit. Great. That's flint pit. Here. Smoky peaks. There's a narrow pass through the mountains to the south that leads to the heart of the lands to the south coast, a core of the Owen Rebellion. A mighty fortress blocks the path. Owen rebels line the ramparts, a sufficient force to repel any assault from the Masha. If this pass fell, there is a good chance that the rebellion would end. It almost seems like the game itself is trying to push for me to go against the Owen. Okay, so that's the way to Castle Andesite. That's this up here. This road slopes down towards the east shore of the bowl. You see an enormous castle built on the coast. It has been largely abandoned. There are still a few peasants wandering around it, but the castle is overgrown and quiet, as is the road. Let's talk to these people. Several bowl guards are blocking the road. A few are Owen. Most are free. All of them are sweaty, exhausted, and underfed. It seems like they were just forgotten and abandoned here. They dutifully rise and move to block your path. They don't even draw their weapons. Their leader asks, "Who are you?" "I am an explorer from Haven. Please stand aside." They are quite surprised. "Haven is back? Really?" Then they step out of the way. "You aren't a looter or a brigand then. I suppose we don't need to stop you. We were just left to guard Castle Andesite." Castle Andesite. Points to the castle to the south. Glorious, isn't it? It was beautiful. Now it's abandoned. Some still work the land, but the castle was left to pests. Why was the castle abandoned? It was at the beginning of the rebellion. We don't know what happened. We serve out here. There was a battle. The Owen fought the guards. The lord and lady fled, we think. A lot of people ran past us in the night. That was a few years ago. Nobody came back to claim the place. Who is in the castle now? Don't know. None of us have been close. Some pest snuck in. We know that. We hear the snarls and hisses at night. Why are you still here? We were ordered. The Lord and Lady made our families guard the land. We have been out, been for generations. We left, but they left. But we still have our duty. They might be back someday. They don't seem convinced. How do you survive? The farmers who remain give us food. They don't have much, but they share it. We keep them safe. I admire your dedication. They smile weakly. You pass. They nod, wave you by, and continue their miserable vigil. We meet a few farmers. After Castle Andesite is abandoned, they stay on. The rebellion leaves this place alone, and they can at least keep themselves fed. They warn you to stay out of the castle. There are lots of beasts in there now. The farmers hear them howl every night. Let's go over here. Get a clear view of the ocean over there. Smart farmers. Their homes, these are the homes of a few farmers who stayed at the castle after the Lord and Lady were gone. Most are free, but a few are open. Your presence makes them nervous. You leave them alone. You approach the front gate of Castle Andesite. This was a beautiful castle once, settled on one of the largest patches of fertile land in the Vole. You would guess that it's been abandoned for 5 or 6 years. The gate is cracked open, inviting you to squeeze inside and get yourself into trouble. Who knows what squatters were attracted to such glorious estate? Let's find out! You step inside Castle Andesite. It is a glorious old castle, even by Haven standards. The Vole truly know how to work stone. However, the castle has been abandoned. There is trash everywhere. Also, unnervingly, bones. You hear snarling and hissing coming from the broken windows above you. This place has been abandoned for years. At least as long as the rebellion has been going on. For the moment. Lovely, there's already an angry little fire lizard out here. A couple of them. Oh, they're leaping lizards, excuse me. I should have gone to one of the bases before I came here. Tablet has been erected in front of a massive imposing statue of a Vole warrior. There's writing chiseled into the tablet. As you look closer, the writing vanishes. Odd. What a peculiar bit of magic. Alright. Let's go around to the other side, see if there's something similar. Maybe it's something to do with the rebellion. Door's locked. Don't have a key. Any more leaping lizards on this side? Yes, there are. There's also huge lizards. over here that's similar. Let's check these doors. Okay. You step into the castle. The floors are filthy and the air smells of rot. There are tracks of feral beasts in the muck on the floor. The floor and walls are scraped with slashes, and there are splashes of blood everywhere. When the castle was abandoned, there was a massive battle. This was the main dining hall of Castle Andesite, meant for glorious banquets. Now it is in ruin. The carpet is torn and stained, and the expensive hardwood floor is covered with gouges. You find that you aren't the only humans here after all. When you enter, several armed looters step out from behind the pillars. One of them snarls, "You're after the treasure here, eh? Now look. This is our claim, and we'll claim your gear as well."
Thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring that bell to keep notified. And remember to free the feral wildflower in you.